I've done this one before. I'm not sure I have. This is a 2018 Ernie Ball Music Man Cutlass HSS RS RS RM roasted RS I think roasted maple, because the neck is a gorgeous figured roasted maple. There's some lovely bird's eye figuring going on there, and it's got a gorgeous rose board, stainless steel frets. Their own pickups, I believe this is a ceramic humbucker and some single coils, and they're all kind of kept quiet by the silent circuit that is built in and powered by this 9-volt battery. Now, this guitar has been, with all of my Ernie Ball Music Man guitars, has been in hibernation basically since early March 2020, when COVID first hit and struck the Australian music industry, at least with a big blow. It means we couldn't play or travel anywhere for quite some time, so I thought, just as a token, I'll put the touring guitars, which this is one of, into hibernation until better times, or different times. And unfortunately, those different times are upon us now, as we all know. The Russia-Ukraine thing is not good. So I thought, well, I've got to bring these guys out. Maybe they'll give me some good luck. So I pulled this guitar out of its case, and the first thing I noticed was that there was some corrosion on the high E string saddle. It also had the top on the saddle protector on top of the bridge. Now, I'm not a big fan of that, so first thing I did was unbolt the protector with a couple of Phillips head screws, which you'll find under the bridge for anybody who's got one of these guitars and wants to make it look kind of oldish like this. Ditched it. Then I took the saddle off and cleaned it with some silver polish, which took a little bit of bit of elbow grease and some very fine grit sandpaper to help finish the job. Then I reassembled the bridge, put some Ernie Ball Slinky 10-46s on it, and gave the neck a tweak and the guitar a general polish, and she is as good as gold and reminds me in every way why the Ernie Ball Music Man guitars are probably the best production guitars coming short of a custom shop. And in fact, they even beat most of the custom shop guitars that I've played from the two big companies. They're just amazing to play. Rounded fretboard shoulders, stainless steel frets, that gorgeous neck with, you know, the little spoke wheel tweak adjustment, which didn't need much. You've got Scheller S6 locking tuners here, height graduated. There's no pull on the nut here. And just the two-point bridge, which works a treat. So I've been mucking around with it this morning before I go to the gig. We're on tour with the Red Hot Summer Tour around Australia for the next few months. I think I might take this with me now. That's a Soldano 88R preamp, courtesy of the mighty Axe FX 3 over there behind me. So I'll just give you a listen to these clean tones. So that's the humbucker on its own. In position two with a single coil and the humbucker. You know, it's got that quack that is often called for. The middle pickup on its own. Position four, these two. Oops. And then the neck pickup. Mm-hmm. So the strings are still stretching in, but they're great. And this is great too. If you're looking for a top shelf production model, you know, guitar of this nature, and let's, you know, not pretend that it's not drawing its heritage from the classic Fender Stratocaster, which it is, but you'll find that the Music Man neck is unbelievably comfortable. It's got a wax and oil finish. It's about 41.3 mils at the nut, I believe. The neck feels a little bit like the Axis neck. I've got a couple of Axis guitars here, and they're great. And the pickups are good. That's a pretty warm ceramic. Pretty warm ceramic humbucker at the back. And these have just got the right amount of quack. Just go back to the clean tone. So I think it might be time to put this guy back on the stage with some of its friends. See you soon.